Greetings, minions. I am your humble narrator, Sideways Thinker, and I'm just here with a bit of a brand new Imperious Impressions. This time it's of Massive Chalice on that there PC. Right, for those of you who don't know, I'm going to just turn the heater off here, but for those of you who don't know what Massive Chalice is a squad-based, turn-based RPG, strategy game, I should say, being developed at the moment by Double Fine. It's currently in early access on Steam, and I believe it was a Kickstarter game. I say I believe, knowing that entirely to be the case. The game is kind of split into two primary halves. This is kind of the overworld half, where you're kind of the kingdom management half, where you've got all of these different provinces in your nation, and you've got to, you know, do whatever you can with the various places and protect them from all this horrible black shit that's slowly encroaching from beyond. You can see a bit of the encroachment over here, and I believe that's the salt stacks. So yeah, that's a thing that happens. Just trying to think. There is, of course, another half, which I'll hopefully be able to show you in this video, which is the combat. Now, this game has quite a strong focus on... the kingdom management has quite a strong focus on family lineages. As you can see here, I've got three houses right now. House Rydal, that's one that I literally just made. House Wield, which is one of the ones I started with. And House McLean, which is another one of the houses that I started with. There's kind of an inspiration with Game of Thrones in this. Like, there's elements of it. I mean, like, you know, one of the things is the chairs, kind of vaguely reminiscent of it. You can see here that we've got, like, the name of their fortress. And in the case of House McLean, it's Dub Arid. I'd say Dub Arid. And they've got their own little... their own motto here, which is, as you can see there, conquer or die. And they also actually have, that's their house words, they also have a battle cry, which I believe House McLean is for the king. If you go on House Wield over here, you can see it's House Wield of the Wield, with their words, undying unity, wield eternal. Let's quickly have a look at the last one, House Rydal, which is one that just kind of I randomly got one here. Yep, Rydalsborg. I cannot read that. I think that would be something like Fortudo et Constantia. I don't know what that means. That might be Latin, that might be Italian, it might be Spanish. I have no idea. And of course, we've got our regent there and our hunter making various different children. Basically, what you end up doing when you're making the houses is you have to... Because obviously, you've probably noticed... Let's just go on Wield, because I like Wield. You've probably noticed that there are... two people standing here. There is the regent, which in this case is Shanalee Wield, the Lady Wield, and Hagen Nim, who is a member of a different house, who is married to the regent, and the blood of these two goes into their children. In fact, I don't... Nope, we've got no one here, but you can see actually they've got one child at the moment, Andar Wield, who is a hunter, because these two were both hunters as well, so it makes sense. But yeah, so all the different characters have got personality traits. You can see here from Shanna, Hawkeye, Puny, and Kingmaker. And, you know, there's the genetic traits, and we have personality traits. Nim's got his own. Hawkeye, clumsy, asthmatic, reckless. And Andar, you can see here, has got Hawkeye and Quick Study. And Hawkeye, he almost certainly inherited from his mother and father. So yeah, the genetics, the genetic traits of the older characters of the parents does have an effect on the children. Also, how experienced the regent and partner were as combat characters does have an effect. We're also over here right now just making the Sage Rites Guild, which as it says there accelerates the rate of research, because as you may be able to tell by this little time bar up here, this game has a big emphasis on time moving forward. I believe the game will end, or will hit the end game, in about 285 years when the chalice is fully charged, the titular massive chalice. And we play as the immortal king, who has the ability to stop and start time. at the minute we can't research anything because the game doesn't have like research resources really. Some items that you can research, like armor, you have to kill a certain number of enemies or a certain number of a type of enemy to do it. But in terms of the buildings, which are the Crucible, which I haven't built yet, the Sage Rites Guild, and the various keeps, so you can get new bloodlines or new houses. The only resource is time. Let's go here into the keep where we are based. This is the titular Massive Chalice, which, by the way, is the only thing that speaks in the game. It speaks via voices kind of coming out, like literally lights come out of either side of the chalice with a different voice, I believe. The male voice is, I think the voice actor is called Simon Templeman, or Templeton. Who, for those of you who don't know, he voiced Tern Loghain from Dragon Age Origins, or in possibly what is genuinely one of my favourite voice acting roles in the entirety of gaming, he also voiced Kane in the Legacy of Kane games. And then we've got the female one, who I believe voiced the female Demon Hunter from Diablo 3. See here, we've got all the heroes we currently have. You know, we've got Ryle, Voves, Juniper, McLean, and Weald, which are the ones I started with, and they're all in my Vanguard. And then we do, however, also have some other ones that came around later. You know, Dairing, Ullin, and Noctis. The houses, by the way, when you start, you pick 5 from a massive list of different houses. In fact, there's 2 lists. There's one that's kind of quote-unquote thematic, and one that is silly. I always play with the thematic houses. And I'm fairly certain those are probably made by the backers on Kickstarter. I'm almost certain, because there's like varying formats and quality to the names and the words, so I'm almost certain that was made by backers. We got research here. You can see we can build stuff. Obviously, we can't research anything right now because we're building a Sage Rites Guild, which will actually increase our research and make the speed up. You can see who we've got. Various different things we can build here, you know, the various armors, and we've got Veil Armor and Unstable Carapace Armor, which we can't build yet because we need to kill a certain number of specific enemies. Weapons, very much the same thing. Look into that. Items, same thing as well. You can equip these to your characters and they'll do those things. We've got stuff to recruit new, you know, we can either adopt baby girls, adopt baby boys, or we can just recruit new heroes. We can get a recruitment boost, and this is just a list of our completed stuff. Right, so let's back it up, and let's set time going, and wait for something to happen. And apparently actually setting time moving like that kills the frame rate. Okay, so, immediately, you see here, we've been attacked by the Cadence, which is the name of our enemy in this game. It's attacking 2 territories. I didn't actually decide which one to pick. Can I back out of this? So these are my heroes. Can I back out of this so I can change my mind? Okay, good, I can. You can see here, you get a reward for each one you do. We can either protect... I don't actually remember what that place is. We can protect this place and get a newborn baby boy, or we can protect this place and everyone gets more experience. This is actually quite difficult, because I actually want... I want to protect the land of House McLean, but... You know, because it's just seeds and ruptures that are quite easy to deal with. But lapses. I want to get Void Armor, which is a kind of specialized armor for hunters. So, you know, we'll take the one that's actually got lapses and we'll get the newborn baby boy. Okay, here we have our current heroes, our current Vanguard. As you can see, they are made up of people from the various houses. You know, Ryle, Juniper, McLean, Voves, and Weald. They, at the moment, I think these are almost entirely still my original Vanguard. Actually, I think there might be one of the... I think Voves might not be from the original Vanguard. Yes, no, can't be, because the original Vanguard was a dude. I think. Not sure. But yeah, as you can see here, they've got classes as well. Hunter. Can you tell that I like hunters? Alchemist and Caberjack. There are more classes like than this, but like Caberjack, Alchemist, and Hunter are the 3 basics. Your hunters are your long-ranged and also your scouts, because they can stealth. Caberjacks are your tanks and your kind of like melee damage dealers. And the Alchemists are kind of secondary melee damage dealers, but also kind of grenadiers. You know, you can get various other different kinds. Like, you can get, I think, you can get like boom jacks, I believe it is, who have explosive cabers, who are a mixture of an alchemist and a caber jack. You can get trick shots, which are a mixture of an alchemist and a hunter, which have like explosive arrows. You can get shadow jacks, which I haven't got one as of yet, but they're a mixture of hunters and caber jacks. Basically, you get different classes depending on who the regent and partner are of any given family. They produce children of a different class by mixing the two together. Okay, so let's get in that. Into the chalice they go. Hold your breath, lads.
Hero messed up the landing there. Not a good sign.
And immediately we've been spotted. Okay. Thankfully, they're across a fucking river, so they can't do shit. Hi there. Okay, let's activate our follow-up, which is our two thing attack. As you can see here, the cadence are kind of pseudo-demonic creatures. Yeah, we're not fighting against, like, a rival political faction. We are quite literally killing monsters in this game. Excellent, we got a hit. Can we get another? Yes, we can, but it's not quite enough to kill it. Can you hit it from here? You cannot. So we are going to have to start going the long way around and hope the laps can't hurt us. The various cadences have different kind of one-off gimmicks. The lapses are incredibly annoying because they literally suck the, I probably can't actually throw a grenade that far. I can. Great, let's try this. Excellent, killed the lapse. But the lapses are long range. They kind of throw kind of bolts of energy at you, at your troops. And what those bolts of energy do is they do damage, obviously, but more than this, I did it my way. But no, they more than that, they suck away your XP. To the point at which you can actually lose levels to lapses. They will literally suck levels away from your characters mid-game. You may have also noticed there's ruptures there. Ruptures are kind of suicide bombers, basically. That's what they do. They run up right next to you and they explode. They aren't the most difficult to deal with. I do like think the most annoying is that I've actually no this. Okay, at this point in the game, we haven't actually been introduced to the other form, to like one of the other forms of cadence, called withers, that like are melee attackers who fucking age your characters and can kill them of old age, like during a fucking invasion. Like you can literally have a character die of old age just out of fucking nowhere. It's really annoying. We've got ruptures. Ah, good, they're keeping close, so I can use my grenadier. Assuming that this fucking lapse mystically, thank fuck that missed. I hate lapses, I mean, Jesus fucking Christ. But no, lapses are very annoying, long story short. I don't like lapses. Okay, let's chuck a grenade. It's most likely a hit there, so. We're lucky, oh, it very nearly killed both of them. Okay, you kill that. Grand. Damn, I was hoping that would do, like, just enough damage to, knock it out. And you shoot him, and hopefully that one... God damn it. Hunters miss a lot. It's a problem the hunters have. Especially given the fact that hunters... Some characters have optimistic, which means that they actually give you the,
I think it's... back to that sludge from Windsnake Kane.
Yep, that's Kane speaking. But yeah, some of them actually have this really annoying trait where the percentage chance to hit is a lie. Like, they overestimate how likely they are to hit things. It's incredibly annoying. You may have noticed, obviously, the ground there has gone a bit of an odd colour. Basically, don't stand in it is what that one means. Just don't stand in it or you will take a point of damage. Oh good, we've got our caber jack. Our caber jack has lone wolf. That's a really stupid thing for a caber jack to have. I mean, it makes sense for a hunter to have that, but not a caber jack. Okay, hopefully that's far enough out. But yeah, that's honestly one of the big complaints I've seen about this game so far in the user reviews, is a lot of people don't like the fact that the cadences are very much one-trick ponies. You know, they have one... they have like one thing that they do and they like never change, they never waver from that one thing that they do. Come on, make it. Damn. Oh well. At least by virtue of being a higher level alchemist, dude does have two attempts to hit enemies each turn. So that's cool. And let's give it a go. Oh, the problem is that alchemists actually run out of grenades, essentially, or flasks, as they call them in this game. They do actually run out, which is a bit of a pisser. There also isn't any kind of Overwatch, which is annoying. But then again, that may just be because I'm so very used to playing games with Overwatch that I... you may say I somewhat over-rely on Overwatch. I always feel sorry for my Caber Jack when it's, like, ruptures and... when it's ruptures and stealth her over here. When the enemy is like literally all ruptures because they don't have much to do to Caber Jacks. Because you can't have them hit a rupture because a rupture, if it gets too close, ruptures explode. Like that's just what they do. They blow themselves up in order to do damage to you. They are suicide bombs. So the idea of having a fucking Caber Jack run up and fucking belt one is kind of silly. The only use I've ever had for a Caber Jack in these is, like, they have an ability where if it successfully... Shit, please don't. Please don't, 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 please don't. God damn it, it's gonna explode. It's gonna hit three people. Shit. Oh, they're all standing in goo. Oh, that's not good. That's not good. Thankfully, ruptures don't do that much damage. Like, and one rupture exploding will not... is almost certain to not kill a full health. Okay, let's just keep moving our hunters up in secret so we can scout out what's going on. Like a couple of ruptures there. Hopefully, do I still have any flasks on my alchemist? Something very cool about the. By the way, in case it's not obvious, I like this game. I should probably be saying that right now. I'm quite fond of this game already. A bit keen. Okay, so let's run him up here. Hopefully they won't have... Okay, good, they don't seem to have spotted that. And now... Oh no, wait, shit, I moved him slightly outside of his walking range. Yeah, you've got, like, a walk and a sprint. And the sprint, you've probably figured out what the sprint is. And oh god, that's gonna blow up and kill. Okay, it didn't kill anyone, it just hurt my alchemist. I don't have much use for my alchemist at this point. Oh, god damn it, the Caber Jack's getting hurt. Okay, here we go. I'm gonna get the Caber Jack out of here. You know what? I'm gonna move the Alchemist first, and then I'm gonna get the Caber Jack out of here. Hi, I'm an Alchemist. I'm gonna throw this at you. That's gonna miss, and I'm gonna run away. I'm gonna get the fuck out of here, like, right now. Yeah, right now. Fuck it, let's open fire with a follow-up. It should be enough to kill the rupture, if it hits. Excellent. It's relatively rare that the follow-up shot doesn't hit. Like, it really is quite rare. Yeah, you're already kind of seeing some examples of the, you've already been seeing, like, examples of the, you know, the other set of words that each house has. You know, while we're just, like, doing this mission, I'm going to talk about just, like, you know, my experience with this game. And that is, I had no idea that this game existed until I randomly was looking through... I was just looking through Early Access games one day. And I just happened upon this. And I had never seen this game before. Like, this was new to me. Let's hit that one. Oh, not. Let's not hit that one. Let's, like, really dramatically not hit that one. Just move forward and keep invisible. Don't want to reveal myself. Because of that, that's why I don't want to reveal myself. Because shit like that. Okay. If I move here, can I hit it? No. Fuck. Go invisible and hide over there. But yeah, I had no idea that this game existed, and even when I, like, sent off the request for a press copy, I was a bit dubious, mostly because it's a strategy game by Double Fine, and I'm not particularly pleased with Double Fine at the moment. Believe it or not, not a big fan of Double Fine right now. because of what happened with Space Base DF9. Oh god, I think Wheel is actually gonna die. Okay, no, he's not necessarily gonna die. Okay, cool. Okay, he's gonna take damage, and we're gonna wanna get him out of there as quickly as possible, and just keep him away from all fighting from now on, because he is very close to death. I'm getting the feeling that we're quite close to winning right now, though, anyway, so shouldn't be too big a problem. Let's move you up here so we can actually reveal that. You go up there, because we've got no use for you, because I'm not having you fucking run headfirst into one of the goddamn Cadence, because that would be really dumb. And let's just confirm an attack on that. Should draw its attention. It'll run straight for me, so... Okay, end turn. But yeah, no, I wasn't particularly excited about this. I mean, it sounded cool, but then again, so did Space Base DF9, and Space Base DF9 ended up, second. That's unfair. Space Base DF9 was a good game. They just didn't finish, the bastard. So... Yeah, there we go. Let's get... Okay, cool. Can I get it? Or... Nope, not quite. I'm actually gonna have to have this guy come and smack it in the face, and hopefully...
Send them back to that slot.
Cool. Just enough to kill it. Well, actually, no, not just enough to kill it. But it killed it, and I'm happy. That's all that matters. And let's get a knockback. Oh god, that probably wasn't good, because now if this woman actually makes that hit, it's gonna... Oh, whatever. We'll survive. Ah, actually, no, it's gonna work out brilliantly, because I can actually move at least one of those guys away from there. But yeah, no, for those of you who don't know, I have my Space Base DF9, they just never finished it. They just kind of one day, like, halfway through the early access, decided that it was done and stopped developing it to, like, great annoyance, because it was nowhere near done. Like, it was nowhere near the state they promised it would be when they completed it. So, it was kind of a joke. This, however,
good?
Isn't a very...
Outstanding.
This, however, is in a very good place right now. Oh, that's really annoying. We didn't bloody, level anyone up. Oh, well. But yeah, this game's already in quite a good place, and it's been being regularly updated since, like, apparently 2013. Our tactical team has rescued a baby boy who should be trained at a stronghold. Actually, let's send it to Wield, because they don't have much in the way of trainees, so... There we go. You've got yourself another trainee there, Wield. You just see the fucking nobles of Wield very slowly aging. Yeah, so that's the combat. Hopefully, I'll actually be able to show you the sage rites before the video ends, because, frankly, there's something about the way the sage rites look.
I remember the day I really finished my training and set off for the capital.
Ah, we've actually...
There was a lot of crying.
Yep,
mostly
we've got...
from the kids I crushed during my advanced gouging final.
Yep,
what a day that was.
We've gotten our first new hero. And our Wield. Kingmaker, Quick Study Hawkeye, Reckless, Lone Wolf, Reveler. Excellent. Mostly good on neutral traits. So it's a good character there. Starts like at age 15 as a hunter as level 2. It's skills there with Mr. Wield. Yeah, and that's how it works. That's kind of why, eventually, like, characters will start dying off, like, the nobles will die in time, all the partners will die, and you have to replace them. I don't know what happens if an entire bloodline dies. I think maybe you just kind of have to put another house.
I believe you'll have your work cut out.
I think you might just have to put another house in there. Okay, what's this? Every now and again in the game, you do get these kind of, you know, choices. There's been an incident earlier today. Catherine McLean was keeping watch at a refugee camp. There was some disorder, and the hero had to step in, but unfortunately, a bystander was killed. The citizens demand justice. What do you do? You know what? Caberjacks, not that important. Imprisoner. Yeah, so, because I'm fairly certain that shit would have gone badly, like, corruption. If you make really bad decisions, corruption can actually go up. Okay, cool. We have...
Ah, Sage Rites Guild. I was always jealous of those in my class who went on to join their ranks. They ended up designing the rotary trebuchet that's still used in keeps to this day, as well as the first Oakenstone crossbow.
First time I went to one, I came in for an armor fitting, and by the end, both of my arms were on fire.
What a bunch of brilliant scamps they are. The first of many, I hope. The thrills of battle are a hard thing to leave, but I always found the thrills of inquiry and invention to be worthy substitutes.
Just don't get carried away with appointments. Sagerites can never return to battle. And last I checked, we still need heroes to win this war.
There we go, we'll just have two Sage Rites. Basically what the Sage Rites do is they increase the... They lower the time it'll take to research stuff. And actually right now we're going to start looking into Hunter Armor. For the simple reason that I like Hunters. But yeah, and actually that's the one thing I wanted to show. Don't they look like Maesters? You know, they've got, you know, they're wearing kind of grey robes. They give up their house and name to just become there. Like, instead of, like, you know, what's his head, I don't know, Wield, or wherever the hell these people came from. Like, it's just Kiri and Josephus. Instead of, like, Kiri Wield, or Josephus Josie Balls. Like, it's, yeah, like, they're probably Maesters. I'll keep going until we hit half an hour, maybe something else will happen.
Sound the horns of passing.
Ah, there we go. One of the regents has died.
It's tough, but now you've got an idea of what to expect from this campaign. Lots of horns.
The partner will return to your retinue, and you'll have to appoint a new regent and partner to continue the bloodline.
And
heroes await your decision.
And because we have to actually appoint one from... because we actually have to appoint one from the... the family, we're kind of out at the moment. You know what? Because it's still a child, and I don't want to have to lose one of my vanguard, or I don't have to lose one of my characters, I will leave it. So that one will just not have a partner until someone else is available, or until a female of another house comes of age. Regent of Woodlands Hold. God damn it! Fucking Wield is gone as well. Shit. There we go. And our Wield. There you go. You can be Regent of the Keep. And super high. Yeah, go on then. Marry a McLean. There we go. We've actually got two quite young characters there. So that should, so they should last a while, creating enforcers. So that's good. That's cool. It's weird. We had like two regents die off in the same time. Oh bugger! We've got another territory attack. Young female alchemists, lapses and seeds. We do need more people. And annoyingly, both of these are already partially corrupt, so... Lapses and seeds, lapses and seeds. You know, we'll deal with this one just because there's a house here. We kind of need it. And what are we missing? We are missing a caberjack of some description. Do we have a caberjack? Yes, we do. This woman. We have this woman. There we go. That'll work. I feel sorry for Michael Wield here, because like everyone else is... a woman, except for him, so he's like the only
guy in the military. He's the only guy in the kingdom military.
There's a stillness to the air right before battle, like the world is taking a deep breath.
Oh, is it indeed?
Now knock the wind out of them.
Okay, so what we're gonna do is we're gonna run up here. Hi, oh god, we've activated another one. That'll be fine, we've got creatures nearby. I don't like how open this particular map is. We'll get to the end of this map, and then I believe we will call that a video. Let's free throw. That should pop and kill him. Beautiful, we've taken out two of our enemies immediately. Love it, absolutely love it. Can I throw a grenade that far? There's a very small chance, let's try it. Nope, actually got closer and killed him as well. So, with our first move, our first character, we've killed three things. Excellent. Ah, and in fact... Yeah, certain characters, they do get nicknames at a certain point. So, Vera the Artist Voves. I think that increases the chance of... there's kind of a system of relics, which are... Like, kind of better than average weapons that get passed down through certain noble families. That is a problem, actually, that Voves has got it, because we don't actually have anyone else of the Voves bloodline. So that is a problem. We don't have any more Voveses. So that is a bit of a pisser. Can we shoot the seed from here? Yes, we can. Let's give it a go. Won't waste my round, my follow-up, because it would hit it. Yeah, no, because that didn't hit. Because it was to hit it either way. And let's... stealth move over here. Yeah, the seed doesn't need to know that there's more than one of us there. And we will actually send you in the other direction. With a caberjack. Because now we've actually got, like, enemies in this area that we can use a caberjack on. We've got seeds that we can hit with a massive fucking stick. So, that'll be good. Oh, we've got a rupture. We've got a rupture. We've got rupture farms, Lydia. We've got rupture farms. Right, here we go. Awesome. Next hit, if it hits, we'll kill it. God fucking damn it. So irritating when this follow-up doesn't hit. Okay, fuck it, you. God fucking damn it. Oh, God. You. No, too far away. You, let's fucking... Autobots, roll out, move, go. Oh, we've just got to kind of... just gotta kind of desperately hope that that rupture is not in range of my hunters. I don't think that rupture's close. No, it's not. It is barely out of range. Let's move her back a bit and have her kill it off. Excellent. That should go boom. Bada boom. Yep. Forever we stay. Oh my God, did she just get the name What's-A-Face? Oh, sweet buttery Jesus. Melaine What's-A-Face Juniper. Love it. That's great. That is an honorable name. That is an impressive name. That is an imposing name. Fuck it. Jesus. Oh, they're both lone wolves, so sending them off on their own is probably a good idea. Nope. Can't actually make her move anymore stealthily, so we're just going to have to make her head out on her own forward anyway. End turn and end turn. So we can send that hunter out for... oh, hello, seed. Oh, two seeds. Isn't that lovely? Well, we've got two hunters, so... oh, that's a problem. That guy's going to be an issue. An issue with a tissue. Okay, send her backwards. Take the crossbow off and fire. Excellent. Come on. Follow-up actually hit this time. Why can the follow-up... the follow-ups can't hit anything. This is weird. Like, I've never had follow-ups be, like, this, like, regularly awful at hitting things. There we go. We killed it. Good. Doesn't matter that we did damage to that guy, because these two can kill these in one shot. In fact, almost all of us can kill those in one shot. Kind of irritatingly, but they can. Because they're seeds, and the seeds are just kind of shit. The seeds are only really a threat if you get a bunch of them. Like, then it's a problem. If you've got a bunch of seeds coming at you. Like, one or two seeds, like, not a problem, but loads. Yeah, it's an issue. One problem this game does have is that, like, after you've fought one battle in every territory, like, it's... the territories are... you know, the maps get very repetitive very quickly. Oh, my phone's running out of battery. The areas do get very repetitive very quickly, and oh God, we missed with both. Shit. At least the enemies can only attack us once. Oh, we've got a rupture. It sounds so weird saying that. We've got a rupture! It sounds like someone's died. Doctor, we've got a rupture! Okay. So flask, we cannot throw that far. We're gonna have to move him back so he doesn't get hit by the rupture. And Huntress, can you fire? You cannot fire, but let's move you forward anyway so he can fire in a bit and end turn. Wait for our two hunters to get punched in the head. Oh, I think there was another rupture there. Sorry, it just occurred to me, was I calling, like, the one male he? Was I calling, like, the one male she? Was that a thing that I was doing? It's probably a thing I was doing. Oh my god, you had 90% to hit, you useless fucking... Sorry, that's... Oh god. Fuck it, you. Let's... Come on, you've got to... Thank you. God, fuck off. Excellent. Excellent. Beautiful. Brilliant. Free throw. There you go. Hopefully that'll stay. Excellent. Stuck the hit. Both of them explode. Is that rupture gonna... Okay. The ruptures explode even when they are unconscious, essentially. Yeah, we need more accuracy with this person. This chick. Okay, you two. Come on. Let's get some actual hits, shall we? Thank you, finally. Never relent. House wheels. Move you back and open fire. Please actually hit.
Oh,
thank God. Forever we stand getting punched in the head by seeds. Ah, what ho there, Rupture. What ho indeed. You, move forward. Shoot it in the head if you would be so kind. And you, my dear artist, puff a grenade. Jesus, 20 damage. Awesome. I think this like one character has gotten like the majority of the damage so far. But that one character's killed more than everyone else. Oh, hi. Hi, Rupture. Are you the last Rupture? Please be the last Rupture. I wanna end the video because we're getting on to 40 minutes and my hard drive is already full from the Game of Thrones stuff. Bang, please. God damn it. Both hit, not quite enough to kill it. And there's another one, of course. There's always another Rupture. There's always another Rupture. Hopefully we can kill this. Cool, this should, if this hits, it should kill it, and it is dead. Nope, go back to Mr. Wheel. Come on, hit, please. Boom! Oh my god, like, we haven't killed them all yet. Where the hell is, like, the last enemies? Like, where are they? Like, there's not much map I haven't already gone over. This is also a problem I have with this game, is it's, like, sometimes you don't know where the enemy is, and the maps aren't, like, necessarily linear. And they can very easily be hiding in fucking bullshit corners like that. Come on. Come on, Wield. One hit. One strike. You can do it. No, you can't, Wield, you shit. God damn it. Okay. Maybe. I don't know if he can. If she can huff a grenade. Okay, apparently she can huff a grenade that far. Free throw. Please hit. Awesome! Loving the artist over here. Shame about.
Okay,
kind of a shame how old
for
she is.
A little bit, but.
I got a what's-her-face leveled up. Put it down. That's a very, very good ability to put it down. Okay, we've got a massive victory. And I believe that is literally exactly as my sister
I'm not laying the blame at anyone's feet, but the corruption in one of our regions is reaching a critical level.
And once it's completely corrupted, it'll be gone forever, along with anything and anyone in it.
Okay, so we're just gonna, next time there's a mission, we are gonna have to go straight there. That's actually the only one that's corrupt at all, so should be easy enough. Right, well, at 40 minutes, that's gonna have to be off me for now. As ever with the Imperious Impressions is, there's gonna be a link to the store page, the Steam page of this game in the description. But yeah, that's gonna have to be off me for now. I've been your humble red side of thinker, and as always, keep calm and carry on. Good day! So, I hope you enjoyed watching that video as much as I enjoyed making it. Let's be honest, I'm not kidding anyone, I don't know if I enjoyed it, I'm a pre-recorded message. Regardless, if you did enjoy it, please like the video, subscribe to my channel, and leave a comment below. I do read every comment I get, I need some form of validation for spending as much time as I do making these fucking things. If you want to see more of my stuff, please have a look around my channel. I've been making videos for years now, so there is a lot of content to see. I also try to upload once a day, 5 days a week, often with some side stuff going on over the weekend, so you may want to check that out. If you wish, you can follow me on Twitter, where I've been known to post inane bullshit on a semi-regular basis, and if you're feeling particularly generous, you can always subscribe to my Patreon campaign. Every subscriber on there brings me closer to not having to get off my fat ass and get a real job. And I'll eventually be able to upgrade my PC and all that shit. Well, that's it for this pre-recording. Hope to see you all in the next video. Now, get the fuck out. This one's over. Leave. Now. Now.